Ayun, there you go. So,
Yung mo.
ayan. Anyway, so, we'll just proceed with another session in analytical chemistry. But before we go to the next one, kasi actually, this is a separate chapter already. Kung napansin mo, di ba, parang for the longest time, we've been studying titration for, I think, 2 months now or going 3 na siguro. But of course, we had a break. I think this is the third chapter supposed to be for titration, no? So, but then before we proceed with that, let's just review, no, very basic concept about titration. So, basically we have four basic four stages for titration, and usually titrations are best seen or illustrated by titration curve. So, ayan yun, no? So, ano nga ulit ang x-axis for your titration curve? It's usually the volume of your what? Siyempre, NaOH and dito, specific yan. But basically, volume of?
Yung titrant.
Very good. So, that will be your titrant. So, sometimes, anything that denotes the concentration, volume ng titrant, pwede yan. Nasa x-axis mo yan. Basta, amount of titrant will be in your x-axis. How about sa y-axis mo? What will be present? So, in your y-axis, you'll have your... Anong parameter ang meron tayo, Josh?
pH.
Okay, pH. Usually, pH, ha? But then, you can also have other parameters such as electrode potential, no? So if you're doing an electrochemical titration, so pwedeng electrode potential yung nandiyan, no? So like what I mentioned, we'll be dealing the specific type of titration kapag nasa electrochemical titration
di
sa
ba
tayo.
Po parang ano directly connected yung ano
Yung
electric
ano?
potential sa ano
pH or concentration?
di ba po sila directly related
Yung ano?
pH po, saka potential.
Technically, related sila kasi nga yung potential, it depends. Kung H electrode, if you have a hydrogen electrode, directly related sila, no? But then, what if it's not, you're not measuring hydrogen per se? Let's say you want to measure calcium 2 plus or sodium plus or any other metal, no? So you'll have a different y-axis. So what's important here is that it's either pH, the usual ha, pH or the electrode potential that you can measure for titration curve. No? So, yan ngayon yan. And then, going back sa titration curve, we have four stages here. Ano-ano nga yung four stages? Kasi this must be clear to you before we proceed sa next topic. Ano yung unang-unang stage? That will be your initial stage. Anong meron sa initial stage, Josh? What's only there?
Yung to be titrated.
Okay, and that's your?
Analyte.
Okay, good. No, so basically, it's your sample with the analyte. No? So si analyte lang yung present dyan. Okay? And then, since you're adding your titrant, no, increasing volume, usually incrementally yan, you'll be changing your pH as well. No? So this one is titration of what? Pataas ang pH. So, sinong analyte?
Some acid.
Okay, acidic. Then, yung titrant mo ay basic definitely, no? So, dahil ito ay acid-base. So, actually, nandito siya. Strong acid, strong base. So, analyte first, then titrant. Okay? So, once you add your titrant here, it will now enter sa another stage. That will be your second stage. And that will be before equivalence point stage. In some books, they refer to this one as your buffer region. Okay? So because it's acting like a buffer.
Okay.
Yeah. This is a buffer region. So if you will notice, kaya siya buffer region dahil ano masasabi mo sa change in pH?
Very, very ano po, slow.
Okay, so you have a very slow change, no? Delta pH is very low, therefore, even if you're adding a strong base like sodium hydroxide as your titrant, pH doesn't change drastically, no? So we can say that this one is a buffering region. And then eventually you'll enter another stage wherein there will be chemical equivalence between your titrant and analyte, and that will be your equivalent stage, okay? So there will come a point, no? So may volume dyan, may specific volume dyan na marireach mo yung equivalence point stage natin or equivalence point, no? So we can derive this theoretically, okay? Pero sa laboratory, Josh, ito yung minimeasure talaga natin, yung volume, no? So kung kunwari there's a change in color, that will indicate your endpoint, which must be very close to your equivalence point. Tama? Kasi sino nga ulit yung anong difference between endpoint and equivalence point, Josh?
Endpoint literally natapos.
Natapos by how or what? Paano malalamang endpoint? Equivalence point ka muna. How will you know it's an it's equivalence point?
Pagano na patagal literal equivalent yung moles.
Correct. Yun ang mahalaga. Equal amounts dapat ang titrate and analyte. Pero ang equivalence point kasi theoretical ito, no? And we don't
and
usually see.
Pa nag-neutralize na.
Ay, di ah. Neutralize. Kasi ko sa bagay, ang endpoint, it must represent equivalence point, no? Kasi at some point here or some way or another, we need to identify equivalence point. Ang equivalence point, ang counterpart niya sa endpoint physically. Realistically speaking, let's say a change in color, any physical change or physical manifestation na magsasabi sa atin ng equivalence point, that will be your endpoint. Okay? Kaya meron tayong tinatawag na if there's a difference between equivalence point and endpoint, anong tawag natin doon? Diba ideally, Josh, kung ano yung volume ng, diba, ang volume mo dito ay 30 ml, diba? Equivalence point mo yan. Paano kung ang endpoint mo ay 35? So there's a difference between the two. Eh dapat equal yan, no? So ideally, in very, very good titrations, or established titration methods, equal. We're assuming here that the equivalence point and the endpoint volumes are equal. Kasi kapag hindi, malaki ang iyong, anong tawag doon sa difference ng endpoint volume and equivalence point volume?
Ah, difference ng endpoint saka na, wala mo.
Ilang beses ko sinasabi yan noong last time.
Endpoint,
Ano bang ginagawa mo? What analytical method is that?
Yung parang
titration. Oh, so error siya. Ano tawag sa error na 'yon?
Ah, titration error.
Good. Titration error is the difference between endpoint and equivalence point. So the difference between equivalence point and endpoint volumes will be your titration volume. Titration error rather. Okay, so once you're done with the equivalence point, you'll now have the after equivalence point stage, no? So, or beyond equivalence, no? So, pag beyond equivalence, Josh, sino na lang yung present dito? Siyempre, yung products, bukod sa products. Sino ang in excess? Kasi dito, ang excess mo sa stage 2 ay si analyte, right? Kasi marami si analyte, eh. Sino ang in excess mo, Josh, kapag beyond equivalence point? Yes, Josh? Sino na yung ano mo?
Post equivalence.
Oh, yung, sa post equivalence.
Base yun. Yung NaOH.
Okay, which is your titrant. So please remember this, ha. Yung apat na yan. Your initial stage, analyte only. Sa second stage, ang excess natin ay si analyte. So, mako-consume or limiting reagency titrant. Sa equivalence point, equal amounts yan sila. Equal mo si titrant and equal mo si analyte. And then, sa post-equivalence point stage, we'll have the titrant as in excess. No? So, we're done with this one. Ayan. Tapos, ang una nating scenario will be, yun yung una, no? Strong acid ang ating analyte, then strong base titrant. So analyte, titrant. We also had the strong base versus strong A. No, so strong base naman yung analyte mo And then, strong acid naman yung titrant. What do you expect sa titration curve?
Baliktad po. From ano,
Ang baliktad.
Parang yung
okay.
Kanina, pero
From
baliktad.
high pH, then paganyan siya. Okay? Pero we can also have, kung ito ay mga strong species lang, no? But we can also have weak species. So, pag weak species naman, just remember na ang titrant mo dapat ay laging strong. Bakit kaya?
Hindi na nga po malaman kung ano.
Kunwari, ayan, kapag strong acid, sino ang analyte mo? Strong acid as your titrant, of course, a weak base. Tapos, weak acid naman, strong base dapat ang titrant mo. So, why don't we have another, I'll just paraphrase the question. No? Why don't we have the weak acid as your tight analyte, then titrant si weak base, or weak base ay analyte, then weak acid ang titrant? Bakit walang ganito?
Kasi hindi nga po complete yung pag-dissociate, so we can't know
very
kung
good.
yung actual
So,
titration volume.
Very good. So, since your weak species, regardless if it's an acid or a base, they are partially dissociated, we're not really sure if the reaction goes into completion. Eh, di ba, ang isang condition ng titration reaction or a titration method, the reaction must be complete. So, X yan. And we're done with this two as well, no? So, meron na tayong case ng weak base versus strong acid and weak acid versus strong base. Ito ang ating strong base versus strong acid.
Ma, okay.
Tapos, ayan. What can you say about the difference between strong acid tsaka strong species versus weak species na titration? Si, kunwari, sa A and B, sino ang titration curve, let's say, ni strong acid versus strong base and weak acid versus strong base? Si A. Si A or si B? Strong acid versus strong base muna tayo. A or B, Josh? Kunwari lang ito, ha? We're now having the strong acid versus strong base. Sino kaya dyan? Sino ang mas ideal na curve? A or B? Strong acid versus strong base? A or B? Si B yung ano, yung dotted lines.
Yung ano
po,
yung weak. Yung B yung weak.
Okay, so siya ngayon ang weak acid versus strong base. Tapos ito ay yung strong acid versus strong base. Bakit?
I don't know. I think
anong masasabi mo dun sa strong acid versus strong base? You have a pronounced what? Ayan, no, ang haba nito.
Ah, pronounce yung ano ba? Parang yung ganun.
Anong tawag nga dyan?
it's the
that's your?
May lamang, the length of yung parang equivalence na, na parang
no, that's your pH break.
pH break, ayan.
Or yung ano mo, yung parang inflection point kasi yan eh, no? Yung,
yun, yung naisip,
equivalence
yun,
point.
Yung ano.
So, you have a longer pH break if you have strong species versus another strong species. Pero if you have a weak species versus a strong species, you'll now have a shorter pH break. This rule applies also to concentration. Ito yung sinasabi ng slide na ito, no? Kapag mababa, ayan, no? Mababa ang concentration, ah, sorry, dito mababa. If you have a stronger or higher concentration, no? So let's say 0.1 versus 0.05. 0.1 molar NaOH versus 0.05 molar HCl, you'll obtain A. Pero if you have a diluted solution, let's say 5 times 10 to the negative 3 molar HCl versus 1 times 10 to the negative 3, 5 times 10 to the negative 4 rather, molar HCl versus 1 times 10 to the negative 3 molar NaOH, which is a much diluted, ano no, more diluted solutions compared sa nauna, you'll also obtain a weaker or a shorter pH break. Ngayon, Josh, ano ang advantage kapag malawak ang pH break? Can you give me an advantage kapag malawak yung pH break? If you have a longer pH break, what's the advantage for that? Yes, Josh?
Mas malami pong yung, ano na yung, you can see the transition for longer.
Or, yeah, transition is wider. So, the pH transition is wider. Ano naman kung wide yung transition niya, yung pH transition? You can have, what? Kung mahaba yung pH break, ibig sabihin, madami yung, malaki yung jump, no, ng pH. So, pronounced nga yung pH break, eh. So, pronounced din ang change. Ibig sabihin nun, pwede kang gumamit ng maraming what? Yes, Josh? Kasi pag mahaba ang pH break mo, ibig sabihin nun, you can use what?
You can use yung ano po, tagan na N, yung all three of them. Yung nandyan po.
What are those three? Ano yung mga yan?
Toctaline, bromothymol blue, tsaka bromophysyl green.
BCG, oo. Bromo. Ano yung mga yan? Those
indicator.
Are your... Correct. So, indicators. Please take note, ang pagpili ng indicator pala ay pwede rin makita sa titration curve. No? If you have a long pH break, it means that you have a variety, no, of indicators. No? Kasi nga, sakop niya yung buong ano na yun, eh, kung ano yung transition color range, no, ng color change range ng ating indicator. Kung pasok siya dun sa pH break, we can use that. No? So, let's say for A, yan. So, curve A mo, Josh, sinong mga indicators ang pwede? For curve A, yan. No, burahin ko ulit to, ha? For curve A, Josh, sinong mga transi sinong mga indicators ang pwede?
For curve A, yung all three of them.
Correct. Phenolphthalein, bromothymol blue, and bromocrisol green. Paano kung curve B ang meron ka? Which is the case for weak acids and weak species versus strong species. Sino ang iyong ano ang gagawin mo or gagamitin mo indicator?
Yung ano na lang, si bromothymol blue.
Correct. Bromothymol blue na lang yung may iwan. Good. So, ayan. Nakuha mo pa to, no? So, okay na tayo dito. Okay. So, please take note, Josh. This is a table showing you on how to calculate weak species versus strong acid. So, kasi dito na nag-i-start yung four stages, eh. So, let's say weak species versus strong species. Let's say we have a weak acid as your analyte, no? So, sa umpisa, sa initial, weak acid lang ang meron. Kapag nag-start na mag-add ng titrant, Josh, ano na ang mabubuo? Ano nga ulit yon yung stage 2 mo? What's your stage 2 again, Josh?
Yung ano, talagang, yun nga, yung equivalence mo.
Oh, hindi ah. Hindi ka pa sa pre-equivalence point. What can you say about the pre-equivalence point? Correct. Sino ang present doon sa pre-equivalence point?
Bosa na ba yung yun nga yung talan yung something sabi ay yung titan sa kaanlet both
Oh,
present.
may titan ka ba sa pre-equivalence point? Pre-equivalence point.
Di mo ba meron pa pong konti na lang?
Wala na. Kasi pag pre-equivalence point, you're assuming here that the titrant will be consumed already kasi siya ang limiting reagent mo. Kasi ang dami mong analyte, eh, no? So, in excess si analyte ngayon. So, let's say that will be your weak acid. However, you also form what? If you have a weak species, you're forming what? Let's say weak acid, Josh. Ano ang isa sa mga product?
Weak acid. Yung ano na po, tawagin yung counter ion na.
It's not your counter ion. Don't call that your counter ion.
Salt na.
It's not your salt then. Weak acid ito. So what's the term, specific term for that? Let's say yung weak acid mo na neutralize siya ni strong base NaOH, it will form what? It's what?
It's conjugate.
Conjugate?
Acid. Ay, conjugate base.
Okay. Uy, laging partner yan ha, weak acid and conjugate base. If you have tingnan mo Josh, mixture ito ng weak acid and conjugate base. So ano yan? Ano yung mabubuo mo? They are in the same solution.
Ah, yes, buffer solution.
Very good. That's the reason why. Anong ginagamit sa solution? Tingnan mo, pagkuha ng pH. Ano to? Sino yan? Because I'm giving you pattern to solve this. pH is equal to pKa plus log Ca minus over CHA. Or? Very good. The Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. Or that's the your pKa plus logarithm base over acid. Okay? Tapos, at equivalence point, Josh, tingnan mo ha, at equivalence point, sino ngayon, saan de depende ang pH? How can you solve your pH there?
Good idea.
Sino ang nabuo? And at equivalence point, sino ang in excess? Analyte or titrant?
Titrant na mo.
Titrant? Equivalence point?
Ah, wala pa mo. Pero pagkatapos
Wala
na.
talaga. Yes, correct. Equal kasi sila eh. So, how can you decide for the pH? So, sino ngayon ang nabuo? Sino yung
Ay, yung mga
pinakamarami?
water sa salts.
Yung conjugate base ngayon ang madami. Ayan o, si A negative. And apparently, since this is a conjugate base, we can use the hydrolysis formula. Kaya nga sabi ko sa'yo, babalikan natin yung equilibrium eh. OH minus is equal to the square root of KW over KA and that this is basically your KB. Tama, di ba? KB ito ng weak acid mo. How can you get the KB? You go to the formula, KW is equal to what, Josh? KA times KB. Yan. That will be your KW. That's the reason why ang formula
KG
talaga
ba?
kasi ganyan.
Ba't
OH
KG ba?
minus, ha?
Bakit KG ba? Hindi ba po KB?
Ano
Ano
KB?
lang ba yung pagsulit na po? Okay na
Ah,
po.
oh, KB ang KB, sorry. So OH is the square root of ito talaga yan, KB times the concentration of your conjugate base. However, you don't have the value of KB kasi weak acid ito eh, di ba? Hindi naman nire-report ang weak acid as KB. So, you derive the KB using this one. That's the reason why it will become KW over KA times CA minus. So, kung ano man yung concentration ni conjugate base mo dito, i-times mo sa KB, get the square root of that, then you'll have the OH minus. So, anong makukuha mo muna sa dito? Hindi mo makukuha directly ang pH. You just get the OH, the POH, and then madali na lang naman yan. 14 lang naman yan. 14 minus POH, you'll get the pH. Okay? So, then finally, sa last stage, you now have a lot of OH minus. So, usually, si OH minus na yung magdidikta ng pH. In fact, POH ang makukuha mo muna, then get the pH. Okay? So, ito yung ating, si number one, ito yung, sino ito? Ayun, weak acid versus strong base natin. Tapos, sa solve na natin ito, si number two, this will be your weak base, then ito yung strong acid natin. So, basically, we're done with the four types ng titration. So, wow, tapos na tayo, Josh. You know, strong acid versus strong base versus strong acid, weak acid versus strong base, weak base versus strong acid. However, hindi kasi ganyan kasimple. Paano kapag marami yung polyprotic ang acid or polyabasic yung base mo, no? So, but before we go to there, alam ko na discuss na rin natin to, no? Ito yung effect ng acid strength. Paano kapag ang Ka mo ay lumiliit ng lumiliit ng lumiliit? Let's say, this is your strong acid, Josh. Ito. Yan. Ito yung titration curve ni strong acid. What can you say about the titration curve ni strong acid versus your strong base? Haba ulit ang pH break, right?
Oo, pero parang...
Tapos, gaano kadaming indicators ang pwede mong gamitin?
Lahat.
Lahat. Correct. Paano kung nagkaroon na siya ng Ka? Kasi ang strong acid, ano ang K ng strong acids? Anong equilibrium constant ng strong acid, Josh? Oh, Josh, anong equilibrium constant ng strong acids? Strong acid yan, ha? So, it means they are... Anong masasabi mo sa dissociation?
Wala 100%
Okay, fully dissociated. So, what can you say about the Ka or the equilibrium constant? Product over reactants. Diba, ratio yan? Ang equilibrium constant product over reactants, ganun ka mag-derive din kasi alam mo naman yung mga formula niyan eh. So, dapat from the formula, you can always explain yung situation. So, dahil ang strong acid mo ay fully dissociated, so what can you say about the ratio between the products over the reactant? So, basically, yung reactant mo ay zero na, right? Kasi nag-start siya, kunwari, HCl. So, kung
Completely
ano man
anong
yung concentration nun, oh, ano mangyayari sa ratio? Ay, asan na yun? Yun. Sige nga, balikan natin to. Okay mo. Oh, kunwari, ah, practically, pwede nating isulat to eh. Yan, oh, H plus over HCl. Eh, kaso lang, ito ay fully dissociated. So, meron ka bang inaasyong pang natitirang HCl? At equilibrium. Kasi ganito yan eh. Yan. HCl going to H plus plus Cl minus. That's your equilibrium reaction. Pero hindi naman nga siya. Alam natin per se, hindi ito equilibrium reaction, right? Because this is just a forward reaction. So, but if we will follow the equilibrium constant expression writing, no, on how we write the this equilibrium constant expressions, we'll have the equilibrium concentration of H plus over the equilibrium concentration of HCl, which is practically zero. What can you say about the K of strong acids, Josh?
Ano po sila tawag ng very low yata, wala mo. So, ano nga na?
Fully
K.
dissociated
Ano
sa
pala?
HCl. So, anong value ni HCl dyan sa ilalim?
Zero.
Practically zero.
So,
And what's the answer?
Kung very, very small, limit na lang po siya. Malaki.
Correct. Ang K mo ay sobrang laki. In fact, minsan pa nga ang definition kay K ay indefinite. No? Or wala. Kasi di ba anything divided by zero ay mathematically, tama ba ang term ko? Mathematically, hindi naman siya nasa-solve. No? Or indefinite yung number mo. So, very, very, very large ang K mo.
No po, yung
okay.
Either very, very large, infinitely large, or infinitely small,
Undefined.
divided by zero.
So, ngayon, what if you have a weak species, let's say Ka2. So, palitan natin yung ano ko ha, aking pen, color ng pen. We'll have the yellow one. So, let's say Ka times 10 to the negative 2. Ito na ngayon yung magiging transition, titration curve mo. Ayan. So, same pa rin naman dyan yung NT. O, Josh, what can you say about the pH break ni yellow curve? Acid with 10 to the negative 2 Ka. Ano nangyari sa pH break, Josh? Ka
Acid.
10 to the negative 2.
Lumit, pero
Umikli ng konti. Sinong mga indicators ang pwede mong gamitin?
Still on. Wala lang
Very
pala.
Good. What if 10 to the negative 4 na ang Ka ng weak acid. Ayan. So, same ending pa rin naman. Ayan na siya. What can you say about the pH break? Yes, Josh? What can you say about the pH
Mas
break?
maliit na po siya ngayon.
Ngayon,
Pero,
sino na lang yung indicator na pwede gamitin? Can we use bromocrysal green?
No more.
Okay. It's only bromothymol blue and phenolphthalein. What if we have a weak acid pero Ka ay 10 to the negative 6 na? We have now a very a smaller pH break. So, can we use bromothymol blue as an indicator pag 10 to the negative 6, Josh?
No.
Definitely no. And kung hindi na pwede si bromothymol blue, wala na rin si bromocrysal green definitely. And we can clearly see here that the bromocrysal green transition range does not even fall dun sa 10 to the negative 6 na pH break. Paano kapag 10 to the negative 8 na, Josh? Ayan. What can you say about the 10 to the negative 8? Can we still have a indicator there. Sige nga. Practically, 10 to the negative 8. Paano pag 10 to the negative 8 na, Josh?
Wala na. Actually, pwede, pero wala na mo.
Very good. Pwede pa rin naman yung pinultaline. Yun nga lang, baka hindi tayo mabigyan ng sharp endpoint. This is where the turning point, no? Wherein that we need to consider the strength of the acid, no? Yung Ka niya. So, ibig sabihin, pag very small Ka pala, Josh, anong masasabi mo sa steepness ng titration curve? Tingnan mo ha, 10 to the negative 8 pa lang iyan. What can you say about the steepness, Josh? Habang humihina ang acidity. Remember, Ka is also a measure of acidity. A larger Ka means a stronger acid. Smaller Ka, like that, no? 10 to the negative 2, negative 4, negative 6, lumiliit na lumiliit, weaker acid na siya. So what can you say about the steepness ng titration curve?
Ano naman po siya? Wala na halos. Like,
okay. So
mga
you have a
medyo
correct.
linear na po siya.
You have a lower stiffness na, lalo na kung 10 to the negative 10. Almost wala ka nang makuwang line. No? Parang wala na yung inflection point, kumbaga. And you don't have a practically an applicable indicator among the given indicators. No? So, yeah, wala tayong magagamit. Here comes our new topic. No? So, itutuloy natin to tomorrow, Josh, ha? So, I mean, dito tayo. Hindi ba tayo hihinto? Dahil tapos na tayo dun sa parang quick review natin, no? But here's our topic for hopefully this week, no? So, sana this week matapos natin siya. Pero mahaba-haba ito. Kasi ang tinaplano ko, bukas, anakin pa rin tayo. Then sa Webes, ay organic, no? So, upload ko mamaya ang practice set mo sa Alkanes, no? So, yan. Alkanes ang i-discuss natin sa Thursday. Pero practice set iyon. Okay? Then you know the drill. If it's a practice set, Josh, sa... ikaw ang magsasagot doon. Ano?
Wala pong mayayari.
Meron. Ikaw ang magsasagot doon. So, you better review yung Alkanes natin na discussion, ha? So, balikan mo siya. Kasi kung baka nakalimutan mo na yung mga bicycloalkane, spirines, etc. So, I don't know if you can recall them, ha? Naming, properties ng alkanes, yung mga rotations, let's say Newman projection, angular strain, etc. Balikan mo yun, ha? Kasi that we'll be reviewing that on, we badly need them on Thursday. Anyway, let's now proceed with our next topic. Paano kapag complex acid or base ang analyte, Josh? Diba? So, so far kasi, ang dinidiscuss natin ay mga monoproteic. So, monoproteic acids and monoabasic bases. Kung yun yung mga species lang natin, no? One lang. So, paano kung ang analyte mo ay phosphoric acid? Paano kung ang analyte mo, Josh, ay asa na yung next slide? Paano kung ang analyte mo ay carbonic acid or carbonate system or carbon dioxide system, which is a very applicable system sa biological organisms. So, paano kunwari ang ano mo ay sulfuric? So, those things. Ibig sabihin, kailangan nating i-consider yung calculations and how do we create, no? How do we create titration curves for them? Josh, natabi mo ba yung mga ano natin? Titration curves for the first four problems?
Maabo.
Tapos natabi mo din yung may ano siya, yung na first derivative natin?
I think so.
Okay. Anyway, so, idadagdag mo lang ito, no? So, this will be our fifth one. The complex systems. At maraming cases ito. So, makikita mo yung mga cases dyan later, no? So, let's start first by understanding phosphoric acid system. So, phosphoric acid, of course, you know this already. This is H3PO4. And then this one will have a different protonated species, such as your dihydrogen phosphate, monohydrogen phosphate, and then phosphate alone, no? So unprotonated na yon, or the protonated, fully deprotonated species of phosphate. So practically, they are different in terms of their dissociation constants. So therefore, they will exhibit multiple endpoints in a neutralization titration. So can you give me an idea, Josh? What will be the titration curve of a phosphoric acid system? So syempre, ang volume ng titrant mo ay si NaOH pa rin, no? Let's say NaOH has your strong base. Sige nga, drawing mo lang, mag-sketch ka, Josh. Ano ang itsura ng phosphoric acid kapag tinitrate?
Pagka tinitrate mo?
Kasi practically, iba-iba ang Ka nila. The first Ka, when you remove the first proton of phosphate acid, is 7.11 times 10 to the negative 3. Malayo-layo. Ano na yan? Strong pa rin naman, no? 10 to the negative 3. Then, kapag dihydrogen phosphate na siya and you want to remove another proton, the Ka this time is 6.32 times 10 to the negative 8. This one is quite far from one another, no? 10 to the negative 3, 10 to the negative 8, 10 to the negative 5 difference. It's very big, no? Tapos, you'll now have hydrogen phosphate or monohydrogen phosphate and you want to remove the lone hydrogen there to form the phosphate ion, the Ka this time is 4.5 times 10 to the negative 13. So, they're actually different, no? Negative 3, negative 8, and negative 13. So, practically, sabi dito, they will give you multiple endpoints. Then, draw. Sige nga, para lang magka-idea tayo, ano kayang itsura ng titration curve ng phosphoric acid? Sige.
Okay, ma.
Yes, Josh?
Hmm.
Yeah, mag-ano ka lang, annotate.
Okay. Yan. So, alam mo na sana, starting from zero.
Man siya mag- hindi yan mag-i-start sa zero kasi ang analyte mo may pH yan eh.
Ano, parang some sort of. So, dito sa ano, baba. So, something.
I-apply mo na din yung natutunan mo kanina. Di ba habang nagiging weaker ang acid, numinipis nang numinipis yung stiffness. Di ba? Yan yung pinakita natin kanina eh. Make it more realistic. Okay. Pwede na yan. Something like that. Actually, yeah. Perfect. Actually, this is how this is what a phosphoric acid titration looks like, no? Titration curve. So, kasi yung isa, tingnan mo, 10 to the negative 13 na to. So, parang hindi mo na siya masyado makita. That's the end point. And then, this is your second end point. And this is your first end point. So, 10 to the negative 3, okay, pancha, si 10 to the negative 8, kita pa natin yan. And we can use an indicator there. Then, recall, Josh, these are your equilibrium reactions, no? Pwede ba natin tong i-combine, Josh? Let's say the first dissociation and then the second dissociation. Can we combine them, Josh? Yes, Josh. Pwede ba natin i-combine?
Maybe.
Yes, pwede. Diba? Ano mangyayari? Sino makakancel out?
Makakancel out po yung mga H2PO4, mga yan.
Ayan, okay. So, yun lang naman ang makakancel out, Josh. So, you'll have this one, H3PO4. Then, add natin yung two molecules of water here to produce monohydrogen phosphate and then two moles of hydronium ion. What will happen to your Ka? Review ito. Paano kapag pinag-a-add mo ang mga equilibrium reactions? Anong ginagawa mo sa mga Ka's? Pinag-add mo, additive sila. So what will you do sa Ka's kapag ganyan? You're getting a summary. Parang ano siya, no? Ano nga tong, ano? Hess's law. Parang kumbaga, no? Nag-Hess's law ka. So anong gagawin mo sa Ka's? Sa Hess's law kasi ina-add natin sila. Additive ang mga delta
multiply.
G. Yun. Remember this, ha? Hindi ito ina-add. Minumultiply mo ang mga Ka's. Kaya, if you have a summarized reactions to form the monohydrogen phosphate starting from phosphoric acid, you need to multiply Ka1 and Ka2. And the product between Ka1 and Ka2 will be 4.9 times 10 to the negative 10. What if we summarize the three equations? Pwede ba yun? Possible ba? Yes, kasi matatanggal lang naman sa HPO4 to minus, and then you'll form the phosphate ion there. So from phosphoric acid down to phosphate ion already. So you now have 3 moles of water here. So ayan, 1, 2, 3 to form a mole of phosphate and then 3 moles of hydronium ion. So magiging Ka1. Ang Ka nito, Josh, ay Ka1, Ka2, Ka3. That will be 2 times 10 to the negative 22. So parang ayan yung summarized Ka niya, kumbaga, no, nung tatlo. Okay? So just remember this method, no? So parang kapag pinagaan natin or sinisimplify natin ang mga equilibrium reactions, if we add them together, we multiply their Ka's. Okay? So let's now proceed with example pala ito. Okay, sige. Try natin mag-solve, no? Phosphate system. Which is, alam mo na rin na dapat to. Calculate the hydronium ion concentration for a buffer solution that is 2 molar phosphoric acid and 1.5 molar in potassium dihydrogen phosphate. This is quite familiar to you. Ano ito, Josh? Ano yung mga binigay? Sige, anong species to, Josh? Ito. Phosphoric acid. Sino to? H3PO4, right? Tama. And then this one, potassium dihydrogen phosphate. Sino ito? KH2PO4. But basically, KH2PO4 will be dissociated lang, no? Hihiwalay ngayon si K. Kasi group 1 naman yan si K. Practically, you have H2PO4 minus and H3PO4. Ano yan, Josh? You form what, Josh? May phosphoric acid ka, may H2PO4
buffer.
Minus ka. Buffer. Okay, yan mo muna. Alam mo na yan. Stop ako dyan, ha? Alam mo na kung paano isosolve yung pH. How about sa second one? Calculate the hydrogen ion concentration of a buffer. So, ayun, buffer ulit, no? That is 0.05 molar in potassium hydrogen phthalate or KHP. So, ibig sabihin, KHP yung binigay. And 0.15 molar potassium phthalate. So, binigay dito yung Ka1 and Ka2 ng KHP. So, ngayon, ito yung task mo, Josh. Sa number 1, identify mo sinong Ka kaya yung gagamitin mo dyan. Ka1, Ka2, Ka3. Same din sa number 2. Then, calculate the pH. So, paki-screenshot ito, Josh, because you'll be sharing your screen later or your whiteboard. Okay na to. Actually, may copy ka nito dun sa ano, updated presentation. Okay na tayo dito, Josh?
No po.
Okay. Ito ang mga KA, ha? Yung KA values. Sige. Stop share ka na lang and then I'll write. I'll stop sharing and then you share now your whiteboard.
Okay. So, dito.
Okay, asa na yung whiteboard mo, Josh? Because I'll be writing
Tingnan
the
mo.
different key values. Ayan. Then, let me annotate lang. Ay, shocks. Exit full screen tuloy. Ay, ano nangyari? Yan. Mas mag-annotate na ako. Nawala yung annotate ko. Ayun. This is for number 1, ha? Yan, nakikita mo?
No.
KA1 is equal to sorry. Kumakita. 7.11 times 10 to the negative 3. Then, KA2 is equal to 6.32 times 10 to the negative 8. 6.32 times 10 to the negative 8. Then finally, KA3, 10 to the negative 11 ata ito eh. Negative 13 pala. 4.5 times 10 to the negative 30. Ay, nawala ulit ang annotate ko. Sabi niya. Ayun. 4.5 times 10 to the negative 30. O, pakisulat, Josh, yung
Wait
given
lang
na
mo,
concentrations.
may kumaga sa ano,
Ah,
wind
sige,
type.
sige. Isulat mo, Josh, yung given na concentration. So, oh, what's happening?
Okay, so given concentration.
Tsaka yung species, kasi doon mo malalaman kung anong KA yung gagamitin mo. Sige nga, I want you to write the equilibrium reaction starting from H3PO4. Then, identify the respective KA na gagamitin. Yun muna. You start with H3PO4.
Wala, hindi ko kumanap yung ano, yung screenshot sa screenshot. Pwede po i-share yun. Kung bilis na. I-share ko na po sa folder mismo.
Sige. Aha, close ko muna to. I'll share screen again. Yes. And you can still hear me ba, Josh?
Oo.
Okay, good.
Yan.
Ayan, I'm sharing already the screen. That's for your KA. Tapos, ito naman yung problem. Okay na to?
Okay na ba?
Okay na?
Okay na ba?
Ito yung problem. Okay na rin to?
Okay na ba?
Okay, I'll stop sharing and then you now share your whiteboard. You start first with showing the reactions. Or
Bro.
ibabalik kita sa basics ha, kasi yung mga susunod nating lessons, halos puro ganyan. Kaya, very important that you solidify
Wala po
the
talaga.
basics.
Ito lang po yung nakuha. Wala po sa ano, screenshot.
Ayan, oh.
Ito lang
Ayan.
po. Pero yung problem po, wala.
Hindi mo na kuha yung problem. Sige, isave
Hindi
mo na
po.
lang ulit yung
Wala
problem,
po.
ha?
Hindi dapat i-print screen ko po para sigurado.
Sige, I'll share. Then yes, and then this one. Ayan. Go ahead. Please tell me if you're good, ha? We're good.
Wala ba?
Okay na?
Ayan. Abo.
Okay, I'll stop sharing and then
Ayan
you
na.
now share.
Calculate the hydron yung... Dapat nakuha to. Wait. Folders, pictures, screenshot. Okay, nakuha na mo.
Okay, good.
Oops.
Minutes will do for that for those two problems. Think 2.5, okay na yan.
Calculate the hydronium ion concentration for the blah 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 blah. Okay, so
You start first by writing the reactions. Yun na lang muna. Oh, you start with H3. Okay, good. Sige, sige. Tama yan. Tapos, tignan mo kung sinong KA yung involved. Plus H2O. Don't forget the H2O. Kasi from there, may kita mo kung sino yung involved eh. Sinong KA yan? Sulat mo dun sa
Wala. Teka
right
lang.
side niya.
Okay, so KA daw ng something is the dito. KA1, which is 7.08. This KA1. Tapos sa yung K2. Negative something.
Negative 3. Kaya na, sinulat ko dyan sa ano. Nakikita mo yung ano, sinulat ko. It's in the whiteboard. It's written on the whiteboard.
Tama. Tapos sa yung to. Tama ka, stable pala. Alam mo pala, yung tanong ko po, di ba po may H2PO4, tapos saan may HPO4, tapos saan may PO4, PO4 na lang po. Meron ba pong H negative 1 PO4?
Wala na yan.
Nalo na. This one. And something.
H2PO4 minus dun sa second reaction. Okay, good.
Ang sabi yung song na yan. Yung parang 10, ano, na ba? Tapos and then there were none. Wala na. Wala na pong hydrogen.
Yeah, that's the third reaction. Guess what you will do next? Ano nang next step?
Do the ice table. Okay, 2 molars daw. Blah, 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 blah. Phosphoric acid, okay. Tapos, assume na lang na 1.50. Hindi yata kasama itong H2O. Hindi nga. This one is zero. Okay. So, strong acid po, hindi pa lang, hindi pa wala strong acid na itong ano. So, minus yung ano nga na ito. Minus 6. Then that's minus 6. New Zoom whiteboard sa Doom come true. They finally reviewed my suggestion.
Yeah.
Please add copy paste. They actually did it. Nice. Ayan. Okay. I need that space. So, blah, 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 blah. Tapos ang paglalat ng X, Y, Z. Okay. Di kaya po, there could be a formula for this. May lang ba? Sinahirapan na ako. I'm getting lazy. So, kung ano pala, let's say there's A minus X. Tapos on this side, it's B minus X. A B plus X, X. And then here is the K. So then, KA. No. Equals BX plus X squared. So, B plus K. Minus K equals 0. Tama po to. Tama ito.
Tama yan.
Okay. Okay, then yun lang yung ruling principle ko for the rest of lagi ko na sa dito. Red. How do I change colors? Ah, okay, ito.
Do you have the value na for the X?
Wala mo. Why is it one? Di ba na pwede mag-change na color? Maganda gawa na siya. Okay, I have something new to report.
Gusto mo parang ini-edit mo na siya dyan.
Para hindi ko, so talagang, so I will get lazier and lazier po yung ultimate goal. Until I don't need to do anything. Yan. So yun na yung the new. Okay, therefore, yun. Okay. So, therefore, this is 1. Tapos, B is What is B again? Okay, this is B. B. Okay. B plus K. No, it's B. Let's see. Yes, okay. So 1.5. Okay. Let's hope it works. So 7.11. Okay. Negative this. Okay, so ano daw, it says that here it says 9.7.
Course, you get the positive x, the positive value of x. And sino yung x?
I don't know, this one, whatever. So basta I will need to apply that na in the next equation.
Sige, go.
None.
Okay, good. Wala ka pang HPO42 minus, but you have H2PO4 minus, right?
Bro. So I need to add that. Probably
That's very small, 9.377 times the negative 3. You just add with 1.5.
so it did basically nothing. Lang. Parang 1.51. Okay, so is that how the way Zoom whiteboard
Okay.
works? So 1.509377 blah blah blah. Tapos I don't want, I don't want, nakahinayang po itong white space. I'm just going to cross it out. So it will never be used. So dito, no.
Bali si Y ay yung H3O plus na manggagaling kay H2PO4 minus, right?
Opo.
Good.
Bakit negative? Okay, shift solve doesn't work. So, basta yun na lang. One, tapos one. I almost deleted everything. Negative what? Negative 8? Is it safe to say na lang po kasi pag ginawa ko na yung sana na wala na. It's negligible yung then yung pag in-add ko na po to. In-add ko
What's
po
your
to.
why?
Wala mo. Ito, negative 8. Mga 3.08.
Sige, lagay mo muna.
Yan.
Yan yung Y. Please, pakilinaw, Josh, ha? Kasi X yung nakasulat, eh.
Ah.
Kasi yung X mo ay nandun sa taas. Negative 9 na kagad?
Four.
Ah, negative 4. Okay.
I have a good feeling this is wrong. Somehow. I just feel
You
like
don't know, malay mo.
I just feel like my destiny will never be, yung first try will never be correct. I don't know why. Okay, so yun nga daw, blah, 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 blah. Wala na to. It's too negligible. Ay, it's not negligible pala. Okay. 3.088 times 9 negative 4 plus. Not so negligible. Okay. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Recent cup noodles. Unfortunately, I have very sad news mo.
It's really small.
Nemo, it's a complex. Wala mo. Sabi mo.
Hindi complex number yan. May value yan.
Kaya nga ba, so the something must be wrong. Kasi kung complex. Let's hope. Okay, yun. Meron mo. It's not complex this time. Okay. So, nakuha na yung key. Ay, yung, ano, yung concentration. So, add na lang. Okay. Blah, blah, blah. No, I do not accept this. It must be a straight line. You will move here. And you will move here. No. Yes. So now, I can into the straight line over there. Yan. Tapos so hopefully na wala naman po mangyayari mo sa ma. Tadaan! So, yung ito pong ginawa ko last was completely useless. It was all for naught.
Sorry. Then what's the pH?
Lata, like, so this one had no purpose at all because this practically unchanged.
2.02.
No, it's 2.01.
Ay, 2.01. Sorry, 2.01. Okay, let's check.
It's not correct. I know.
De, wait lang. Ah, 7.11 exponent negative 3. Okay. Sige. This is a very good ano no. Very good situation here. Oh, what's happening? You're there. Let me. Oh, nawala na naman ng aking power to annotate.
Oh no.
What's happening? Wait, let me ano lang. Oh. Nawala din yung sinishare mo. Wait, it's still loading. Ikaw naman yung nag-share, Josh, di ba? Pwedeng pa-unshare din, re-share mo ulit. It's not loading on my side. So on my end, it's not loading. Please unshare then. Share it again. Then you listen very well dito ha, yung sa susunod kong sasabihin. Kasi this will give you a clue naman for number two. Or hopefully it will the solution or the calculations will be easier this time. But what have you done is actually correct, no? So, yung process itself. It means you really understand the concept of equilibrium and then its succeeding reactions. Nag-reshare ka na, Josh?
Awa.
Ay, sorry. Ako muna. Ayan. Di kasi siya naglo-load sa akin. Ayan. Can you now see my screen?
Awa.
I'll stop sharing and then share again your please reshare your presentation or whiteboard rather. Okay na. Okay. Where's your whiteboard, Josh? Or at least we can now discuss your answer. Muna for number one, ha? For number two, after nitong discussion natin.
Yan mo.
Nag-share ka na?
Loading.
Ayun,
mo.
loading din sa... Yun, finally! Okay. Ayun, meron din ako. Okay. First things first. So, this is correct, no? So, what you have done is, you started with H3PO4, and then eventually, H3PO4 will give you H2PO4 minus and HTO plus. That's correct. This is the first dissociation for phosphoric acid. And dahil malaki yung Ka value mo, Josh, 10 to the negative 3, what can you say about this reaction? Mataas ang Ka mo. Anong meaning yan, Josh? It mostly favors what? The forward or the reverse reaction? Basically, it's reversible. However, hindi yan equally reversible. Dahil 10 to the negative 3 siya, Josh, what can you say about the reaction? Sinong pinifavor niya? Yung forward or yung reverse? Yes, Josh? Oh, you listen very well dito. H3PO4. Dahil 10 to the negative 3 ang Ka, this is a reversible reaction. However, that's not equally reversible. Which one will be more favorable? The forward or the reverse reaction? Yan, no? 10 to the negative 3. Yes? We can assume here, Josh, that the... What? Ten to the negative 3 ang Ka. So what can you say about the reversibility ng reaction? Sino ang mas wayward? Yung forward or yung reverse?
Yung ano yata mo, tangan. So pabaliktad na. So dapat bigger yung sa reaction side, reactant side.
Yeah, bigger yung sa reactant side kasi nga maliit eh. But compared to 10 to the negative 3, 10 to the negative 8, 10 to the negative 13, okay, relatively, mas pa-forward ito. Okay? Compared dun sa other two. Right? So, if that is the case, Josh, your H3PO4 is the main contributor for your hydronium ion. Okay? Tama, di ba? Also, your H2PO4 minus. However, sa problem na ito, hindi lang kasi si H3PO4 ang nasa system. You also have H2PO4 minus. So this H2PO4 minus, in fact, no, ay nagko-contribute din ng H3O plus. So, and then HPO4 2 minus. So with this Ka. Okay? So it's good that you started with this, no, 2, and then may 1.5 ka. Then doing the ice table, you'll have this. Can you get the pH for this one, Josh? Anong pH for this one? What's the pH value? Paano kung i-consider lang natin yung unang ano, yung unang reaction?
Hmm.
Anong
Wait
pH yan, Josh?
lang. Mga 9 point, ano na. So, dapat mga ano kaya, mga 2, 2.02 ba?
2.02. Okay. 2.02. That's the pH. Yan. Okay. Then here comes your H2PO4 minus. Correct naman, no? Kasi you started with 1.50 and then you realize yung H2PO4 minus mo, dalawa ang source niya. Galing kay H2PO4 at yung dun sa sodium hydrogen, dihydrogen phosphate, dun sa salt itself. That's the reason why it became 1.509377. Then you'll have another Y, and your Y here is the hydronium ion coming from your H2PO4 minus. Okay? So, yan yung galing kay H2PO4 minus. And then, eventually, papunta ulit yung HPO4 2 minus, mabubuo to, forming phosphate ion, and then HTO plus. And, dahil 10 to the negative 13th ang Ka nito, no? Ka3, very small na lang. In fact, negligible to. Ito ngayon yung scenario, Josh. Usually, pag phosphoric acid ang binibigay, and if it's a buffer of phosphoric acid and dihydrogen phosphate salt, let's say sodium dihydrogen phosphate, potassium dihydrogen phosphate, alam mo, Josh, kung ano na lang yung kinoconsider? Ang kinoconsider na lang natin ay Ka1. This is your clue here. Josh, ha, pakitandaan ulit ito. If you're given with phosphoric acid together with its conjugate base, dihydrogen phosphate, you just need to consider Ka1 na lang. Okay? Kasi tignan mo, yung pH na nakuha mo, 2.02. Ano yung pH na nakuha mo overall? Pag tinatlo mo sila, 2.01. Here comes the idea of simplification. Nag-a-assume tayo dito. Ano yung assumption natin, Josh? Ang assumption natin ay ganito. Unang-una, negligible na yung dissociation ni dihydrogen phosphate and ni hydrogen phosphate also. So imagine mo, if your dihydrogen phosphate has a very low Ka, Ka2, 10 to the negative 8, we assume here that the H2PO4 minus dissociation will be negligible. Ano pa yung, what more for HPO4 2 minus or monohydrogen phosphate? We can clearly see here that the dissociation of this one will be negligible. If we assume that way, Josh, we assume also that the hydronium ion coming from your H2PO4 minus will be negligible compared to the hydronium ion coming from your H3PO4 or phosphoric acid. Kasi nga, mas malaki yung Ka value ng phosphoric acid kumpara sa dissociation ni dihydrogen phosphate. And even more, no, way, way larger compared to your dissociation of hydrogen phosphate. So ano na lang yung i-contribute, no, na H3O plus ni HPO4 2 minus, right? So ngayon, i-assume natin dito lahat ng H3O plus ay manggagaling na lang kay H3PO4 and lahat ng H2PO4 minus mo ay nasa salt lang. Ito lang si 1.50 kasi ang liit nga naman din nung 9.377 times 10 to the negative 3 as an additive to your H2PO4 minus, which came from your phosphoric acid. No? So, ang shortcut dito, Josh, ito yung shortcut, Josh. Tignan mo lang kung sino yung given na salts. Ang binigay ay H3PO4, actually, hindi naman salt si H3PO4, weak acid, and H2PO4 minus. From there, makukuha mo, ay, okay, ito yung dalawang binigay. Si Ka1 lang pala ang gagamitin ko. Then you can use the this ice table. Josh, meron kang nakalimutan pa. You have your phosphoric acid. This is the weak acid. And you're also given with H2PO4 minus, which is its conjugate base. What solution is formed? It's a mixture of the weak acid, phosphoric acid, and its conjugate base, dihydrogen phosphate. Anong mabubuo, Josh? Yes, Josh?
I don't know. Probably nothing.
Oh, wait, anong probably nothing? Anong mabubuo?
Yung,
Meron, tingnan mo ha, meron kang 2 molar ni phosphoric acid at may 1.5 molar ka ng kanyang conjugate base na
Buffer.
dihydrogen phosphate. Buffer. And if that is the case, anong formula ang gagamitin natin? Para mabilis yung calculation. Buffer yan eh. Yes, Josh?
Yung ano po, Henderson Hasselbalch.
Okay, page 2 ka. Sige, pumunta ka sa page 2. Use the Henderson Hasselbalch equation this time. Sulat, pH is equal to your H3PO4 concentration is 2. Yung H2PO4 minus is 1.5. Ang kailangan mo lang sa Henderson Hasselbalch equation, you must know which one is the base, which one is the acid. Siyempre, napakadali niya kasi si phosphoric acid kagad yung acid mo. So, automatic base mo ngayon si dihydrogen phosphate. Yes, Josh, pakisulat. So that we can proceed sa ano, next problem. Correct. pKa plus, that's plus. Base over acid yan. A minus over HA yan eh.
Bilawa. So, ano,
yan, okay. So, sinong nasa taas? De, sige, sulat mo muna. Which species is, okay. Okay na yan, diretso na. Sinong KA ang gagamitin mo? KA1, KA2, KA3. Of course, yung involved na species ay was phosphoric acid and dihydrogen phosphate. So, that will be what? Sinong KA ang gagamitin? Sinong KA, Josh, ang gagamitin?
Yung sana po na. Yung first.
Correct. Kasi nandyan yung both species, si phosphoric acid tsaka si dihydrogen phosphate. That's 7.11 times 10 to negative 3.
Plus. Oo. Yan. So it's negative. Okay, wait. Wala mo. Something is not
it's
true.
Not negative. Yes, it's not negative kasi anong pKa? That's negative log Ka, right? Remember ha, ang p function mo ay negative log. It's negative logarithm.
What happened?
And what happened? What's the answer? Dali. What's taking you so long there? Ayan lang, pKa plus logarithm 1.5 over 2.
So wait, something must be wrong. Wait a moment. Why is it negative 0.11?
I don't know. It's not negative 0.11.
It can't be.
Isulat mo na, is equal to negative log, what? Write down.
Negative.
Dali,
wait,
we only have 20 minutes, so para we can
di ba po,
figure
ano?
Out this is one. Sige.
Hindi
just write it down.
Hindi ba po baliktad? Wala po ha? Nalagay ko po siya.
Oh, hindi. Base over acid yan eh.
Base yung ano eh. Base ito po yung base.
Tama,
eh.
Oo, tama yan. 1.5 over 2. That's correct.
So 7.11 times 10 to the negative 3.
Oy,
Kasi
negative log yan. PKA yan eh.
paano ko po my blah plus?
Tama yan. Plus, negative log. It's PKA. No. The formula is correct. PKA plus...
Okay, so...
Ang what I'm telling you... No, that's correct. That's PKA lang.
Alam mo?
That's PKA lang. Tama yun. PKA. Tama yung formula mo kanina. What I'm telling you is you take the negative logarithm of 7.11 times 10 to the negative 3. Not 7.11 times 10 to the negative 3 lang. Magne-negative ka talaga
Okay.
doon.
So, yun pala ba nangyari? I forgot to take the P.
See?
The P function.
Like what I mentioned, P functions are always negative logarithm. That's the reason why you take the negative logarithm of 7.11 times 10 to negative 3 first before, yan. 2.0223 or 2.02, which is practically, ano to? Ito yung sagot mo sa KA1 lang, right? Yung sa kanina? Tama?
Mabo.
Ayan yung sagot, 2.02 lang. O pwede, which is mas tama ngayon sa 2.01 eh, because you already considered pa yung sa second dissociation. However, kapag ganito ang mga case, Josh, ang laki kasi ng difference ang KA1, no? So, take note, ang KA1 mo ay 10 to the negative 3, ang KA2 mo ay 10 to the negative 8, tapos, KA3, 10 to the negative 13 yata, no? Tama ba ako? Yeah, 10 to the negative 13. So, medyo malaki yung difference nila. So, we now consider only 10 to the negative 3, yung first lang. Going back, babalik ako, Josh, ha? What if, kunwari, meron kang 2 molar H3PO4? Ayan. Josh, can you recall, ano yung mga MBE nito? And can you recall what is MBE? Yes, Josh?
MBE?
Mass? Kasi this will be very useful to understand the concept.
MBE mas wala po.
Mass balance.
Balance equation.
Okay, yung CBE na alala mo?
Charge balance equation.
Okay, good. Let's start first with the MBE muna. So kung meron akong 2 molar ng H3PO4 at equilibrio, so this is the total, di ba? The total concentration is CH3PO4, it's 2 molar. At equilibrium, ano-ano yung species na present ni phosphate? So, yung buong 2 molar na yan, Josh, equal yan saan? Yes, I want to get your idea here. Just want to make sure that you are getting the concept of mass balance equation and charge balance equation. Yes, Josh?
Okay, so no. Bilang mo.
So, ano mangyayari? Kasi naintindihan mo na yung sa concept kanina. Naggawa-gawa ka ng mga equations. So, madali na lang sa'yo to. Kunwari, may 2 molar phosphoric acid ka at equilibrium. So, after some time, kunwari, nahalo mo na ng maayos si phosphoric acid sa tubig. After some time, anong mangyayari sa mga species ni phosphate? Sino-sinong phosphate species ang present?
All of them.
Oh, sino-sino yun? First is...
H2PO4, HPO4, PO4.
Yun lang? At equilibrium?
PO4.
Ha? Again?
So, H2PO4, HPO4, PO4.
Yun lang nga na phosphate?
Tabo.
Kulang ka.
H3PO4 pala.
Good. Recall, H3PO4 is weak acid. Meron kang maiiwang H3PO4. Ito yung mahalaga kung bakit siya naka-brackets, no? Kasi ano nga ulit meaning kapag naka-brackets, Josh? This will be your... What again, Josh? Pag naka-bracket, Josh, anong meaning nito?
Ano po, concentration.
At?
Concentration equilibrium.
Oh, very good. At equilibrium.
Oh,
Kasi ito,
no.
imaginein mo, di ba? Concentration din to, di ba? Right? Pero ito yung concentration at initial. So, ito yung initial concentration mo. At equilibrium, however, not all of your phosphoric acid are phosphoric acid pa rin. Some of them were naging H2PO4 minus na or dihydrogen phosphate. At yung iba ay naging HPO4 2 minus or hydrogen phosphate. And naging PO4 3 minus. Okay. May tanong ako, Josh. What can you assume here? Ano masasabi mo sa relative concentrations ni phosphoric acid, ni dihydrogen phosphate, ni hydrogen phosphate, and phosphate? What can you say about the relative concentrations? Yes, Josh? What can you say about the relative concentrations of the four phosphate species?
Yung H3PO4, wala na.
Ha? Anong pa? Bakit wala na siya?
Ah, meron pa pupila mo. So, pawala na pawala. Kumbaga.
Hindi siya pawala ng pawala. Actually, siya pa ang pinakamarami kasi 10 to the negative 3 lang to eh.
Hindi ba pala, yung isabihin ko mo, in pag ganito po yung increasing.
Okay, correct. Ganyan siya. So, if that is the case, Josh, let's say, magko-compare ako. What can you say about the concentration of H3PO4 versus phosphate? Yes, Josh. Kunwari, 2 molar H3PO4 lang yung binigay eh. Yes, Josh. What can you say about the concentration of H3PO4 versus PO4? By value.
I'm not sure. Wait a moment. Check mo. So, yung kanina, sana, Z na, ito mo na. Tapos, dito,
Pero
H3.
kasi ito, Josh, ang you're not listening to me, you're not paying attention. Ito ay 2 molar na lang H3PO4. Wala ka ng 1.5 molar na H2PO4 minus. That's the reason why nilinaw ko yan sa'yo. Ayan yung given. What can you say about the concentration of H3PO4 at saka sa phosphate? Ano to? Greater than, less than, equal, or what?
Ayun pa lang.
At hindi lang siya greater than. Much, much greater than. So, sa mga books yan, tatlo pa nga yan eh.
Tatlo mo?
Oo, tatlo. Oh, ina-assume mo kasi
thought
talaga
they
na maliit.
Who would use yung ganito mo?
Na maliit yan. Ina-assume mo na maliit kasi yan. No? So, let's say, kasi 2 molar phosphoric acid ka nag-start, ha? What if, wala na wala yung annotation ko.
Oh no.
I-compare naman natin yung, let's compare phosphoric acid tsaka yung monohydrogen phosphate. Sige, what can you say about the phosphoric acid tsaka monohydrogen phosphate? Ay, walang aking annotation. Sige, sulat mo, Josh. This time, phosphoric acid, Josh, versus phosphate.
Wala mo. Ayan.
Phosphoric acid and monohydrogen phosphate.
So, phosphoric acid. Okay,
Saka monohydrogen phosphate. Sige, sulat. Monohydrogen phosphate. Sa scenario na yan.
Mga ganun lang.
Good. Ganyan pa rin. Kasi we assume here that the phosphoric acid nga ay masyadong malaki yan. Okay? Kumpara dun sa monohydrate. And what can you say about phosphoric acid this time with dihydrogen phosphate? Okay, good. No, so, we're pretty sure that the phosphoric acid is greater than H2PO4 minus. Okay? So, kapag ganito, Joshua, I'm telling you ha, kasi magiging complex ang mga solutions natin sa mga susunod na slides, Josh. Ano ang pwede mong i-neglect kung ganito siya?
PO4.
At saka, actually, up to this point, pwede mo yan i-neglect.
Yung nakita ko nga po, ito nga po yung nangyari. So, this one, wala halos ang effect.
Yeah, yan nga yung gusto kong i-point out dito eh. Kasi ikaw mismo nakakita na, ah, okay, yung KA3 or yung the third dissociation is really, really small. Kaya pwede mo nang i-let go tong mga to because they will not affect your concentration significantly. Kung error-wise, kasi ang anakem ay error, Diyos eh, no? Kung error-wise ito, negligible ngayon yung errors na yan.
Actually,
You can pass it out.
I'm all about errors, kumbaga yung accuracy.
Yes, correct. Ayun pa, measure of accuracy din, di ba? Kasi makikita mo, eventually, it will boil down to how many significant figures. Paano kung dalawang significant figures lang ang hiningi ko or three sig fig lang, di ba? Tingnan mo, pag nag-Henderson Hasselbalch ka, tapos sinabi ko, use two significant figures in the final answer for the PH. Anong sagot? 2.0 parehas. Right? So why will you, eto ngayon yung concept dyan, Josh, why will you go through the rigorous calculation if you can use the simplified version? Because we're dealing with time this time. This time, we're dealing with time. Time of calculations, Josh. Kaya maganda, kaya nga sobrang natuwa ako ngayon sa calculation mo eh. Nakita mo yung long cut, no? Tapos makita mo, ay, negligible na pala yung sa third. Actually, yung second gan. Negligible na rin yun eh. Kasi at the end of the day, you'll be having 2.02, 2.01 na pH. Very, very close na, no? So, sa real world, okay na yan. Kasi plus minus 0.01 will do. Okay? So, ngayon, this is my next question, Josh. Ito yung susunod kong tanong. Saan manggagaling si H3O plus? Sige nga. Anong mga sources mo ng H3O plus? Kasi ito yung unang MBE mo eh. This is your first MBE. I'm telling you how we're reviewing how to write mass balance equation. So remember ha, ang mass balance equations, Josh, pwedeng isa, pwedeng dalawa, pwedeng tatlo, pwedeng marami yan sa isang system. Pero ito kasi dalawa lang yan. Saan manggagaling ang H3O plus?
Galing from all of them, except PO4C.
Eh, sulat. Sige, sulat mo. So very good, H3O plus will come from H3PO4. Pero yung concentration ba ni H3O plus equal siya kay H3PO4? Sige, balikan mo yung first equation mo. Page 1, please. Page 1, Josh. Okay. Sa unang mong reaction, saan equal ang H3O plus? Ka-equal niya yung concentration ni... What, Josh? Yes, Josh.
So, yung...
Sa first reaction, your H3O plus is equal to what concentration?
X, yung change lang ba?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Sino kaparehas niya? Sinong species ang kaparehas niya ng concentration?
Ah.
Wala si 1.5 dyan, ha? Wala, wala kang 1.5.
2PO4.
Okay, so ngayon, ilalagay mo yon sa MBE. Kasi kaparehas niya pala si H2PO4 minus. Punta ka sa page 2. Go to page 2. Right? H2PO4 minus. Right?
Namamatay na yung ano, namamatay na yung ano,
pad?
Yung tablet, namamatay na po siya.
Sige. Make, charge it first. Dahil mukhang hanggang dito muna tayo sa ano, para next, tomorrow we'll proceed with number 2. At least na-review na natin to. Writing mass balance equations and charge balance equation. Very important kasi ito sa mga next topics na ayat natin. Kasi ito ay complex system, Josh. Unless otherwise, gusto mo gumawa ng program, ayan, di ba, nagpo-programming ka, paano natin masasolve yung mga ganito? Complex kasi yan. Kaya kapag ganito sa anakem, dahil kamay tayo, no, parang manual calculation, we do assumption here and simplifications. Yan, nag-assume tayo na, example, H3PO4, the equilibrium concentration of aspartic acid is much, much, much greater compared to your phosphate concentration, which is true. Napakaliit niya nung phosphate concentration compared to your equilibrium concentration of aspartic acid. So, ulit. So, pakilagay. Saan nanggagaling ang HTO plus mo, Josh? Yes. Ang unang source ng H3O plus ay si H3PO4. Pero hindi mo naman ilalagay yung concentration dyan ng H3PO4 kasi hindi naman sila equal to begin with. Right? So, si H3PO4 kasi, siya na yung nabawasang H3PO4 kasi nag-dissociate into H2PO4 minus and H3O plus. Sige, go ahead, Josh. Your first source of HTO plus. Sulat, Josh. Yes, Josh. Ayan. Kasi ang tanong natin dito, saan manggagaling yung H3O plus mo?
So dito.
Yes, Josh. Oh, bakit kay PO4 ka nag-start?
Sige, ano muna lang.
Bakit H3PO4? Why H3PO4?
Ilang marami po siya.
Go back to your first equation. Sige, balik ka sa page 1 mo. Kailangan mo itong maintindihan ni. Ayan, tingin ka, Josh. Saan ang galing ang HTO plus?
From all of them. Except PO4.
Tama kay H3PO4 siya nang galing, right?
Tama?
Pero sa H3O plus, sa first reaction ka lang muna, sa H3O plus, sino yung kapareha siya ng equation? Sino yung kapareha siya ng concentration rather? Ng value. Sino yung kapareha siya ng value? Di ba x siya? Ang x ba ay 2 or 2 minus x? Di ba? Nagigets mo ko?
Nawa.
Anong opo? Explain. Sino kaparehas ng HTO plus? First reaction lang tayo.
Yung H2O plus, kasi pagkapareha na po yung H2PO4, x po siya pareho.
Correct. Sa H2PO4 minus lang kaparehas niya. Kaya, hindi sa H3PO4 yung ilalagay mo doon. Kasi siya yung H3PO4. Iba yung value niya. Right? So, yun yung una mo. So, H2PO4 minus. Sige, punta ka. Then, succeeding na yon. So, alam mo na yung pattern. Kasi yung value na H3O plus na nanggaling kay H3PO4 or phosphoric acid, will have the same value with dihydrogen phosphate. Kasi pareha silang manggaling kay H3PO4. Right?
Abo.
Sige, go. Go back to your page 2.
So, siya yung
sulat, yung MBE for hydronium ion. So, hindi iyan. Correct? So, supposed to be dapat si HPO4, H2PO4 minus yan. Go. Tapos, sino pa? O, sino ka parehas sa second reaction? Sino ka parehas na HTO plus? Very good. Yan na siya.
Yan na mo.
Tapos, sa... Oy, meron pa! Sa third reaction mo. We're writing all eh. Okay. May susunod akong tanong. Ayan lang ba yung source mo ng hydronium? Sila
no.
lang ba ang source mo ng hydronium?
H3PO4 po.
Sino pa?
Water.
Lahat sila nang galing kay H3PO4. Correct, water. At pag nag-dissociate si water, sino ang ka-equal ni HTO plus? Sa
OH.
Concentration. Good. Plus OH minus sa dulo. Nagigets?
Obo.
Is this clear, Josh? Kailangan malinaw ito. Is that clear? Yung second
Obo.
equation natin? So, kasi sa second equation natin, this one... Excuse. This equation is telling us that the heteronium ion is equal to the concentration of H2PO4 minus because both of them are coming from phosphoric acid. Again, it's also equal, kaya mag-a-add ka, also equal to the monohydrogen phosphate concentration because they came from H2PO4 minus. Tapos, equal din siya sa PO43 minus kasi galing sila dito kay HPO42 minus. So, ia-add mo sila lahat. Plus, yung HTO plus na nanggaling kay water which is equal sa concentration ni OH minus. May tanong ako ngayon, Josh. Ito yung tanong ko, Josh, ha? What can you say about the concentration of OH minus? So, ibig sabihin, anong masasabi mo? I'll rephrase the question. Ano masasabi mo sa hydronium ion concentration na nanggagaling kay water? So, is water your main contributor for H2O plus
No,
in this
definitely
system? Correct. Kaya ngayon to, usually, Joshua, kapag nagka-calculate tayo, tinatanggal mo ngayon to. Explain nga ulit. Can you explain that? Why are we neglecting the OH minus here? Why are we neglecting the OH minus here?
I don't know why. Baka kasi ano po tagan, it's very little.
Why? Why it's very little?
Basically, negligible po siya kasi yung ano, halos hindi nangyayari auto-ionization.
Kasi nga 10 to the negative 7 pa. Another thing, ano pa? Very obvious. Very obvious to. Bakit maliit yung OH minus tingin mo? Kasi to begin with, ano yung system mo?
Acidic.
Exactly. Acidic yung system mo. So, ine-expect ko, well, marami yung OH minus mo. Tinatanggal yan sa calculation. Clear tayo dito. So, kaya ang water, ang hydronium ion mo, ito nga yung susunod ko. Di ba yung pinakalculate kita, pH given si 2 molar H3PO4 tsaka 1.5 molar HPO42 minus. Anong napansin mo doon? Yung third dissociation ay almost, what? Hindi siya almost. It's, what can you say about the third dissociation, Josh? Yes, Josh. Yung sa third dissociation mo, dun sa calculation mo kanina.
Also lang nga pong efekto.
Okay, so masyadong maliit yung nanggaling kay HPO42 minus tapos ka-equal niya si phosphate. So ano pang pwede nating i-neglect dito? Eh no, kunwari gusto mong kunin to yung HTO plus. You want to determine the concentration of HTO plus and you want to simplify things. Ang complicated niyan, Josh, tignan mo ha. Ilang ano yan? Ilang variables yan? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 variables yan. So, to solve 5 variables, ilang equations ang kailangan mo, Josh? Naalala mo? Sa math yan.
Dapat pareho.
Correct. If you have 5 variables, dapat 5 equations yan. Tingnan mo nga, dalawa pa lang equations natin, di ba? Kaya ka nag-a-assumption dito or nag-assume and nagsisimplify. Ano pa napansin mo, Josh? What can you say about the HTO plus? Ang sources niya. Masyadong maliit yung kay?
Yung kay water nga po. Saka,
yung kay ano pa? Yung third. Correct. Masyado tong maliit kumpara dito sa dalawang to. Actually, ito tanggal din to eh. Kaya basically, si H3O plus ay equal lang dito. So actually, sa calculation mo, hanggang dito tayo. Ayan, hanggang dyan tayo. Sa calculation mo ha, ito yung talagang naka-affect lang no, sa ating calculation. Okay? Hanggang dito lang. So, kaya minsan, pag masyadong maliit din yung diluted, kunwari yung H3PO4 mo, tatanggalin mo din yan, si HPO42, diluted. Pag masyadong mas mataas, lalo yung concentration dito, you can remove as well the HPO42-. And we assume here that the HTO plus is equal to H2PO4-. Or we're just considering the first dissociation of phosphoric acid. No? Masisimplify natin yung mga bagay-bagay. Okay, that's your MBE. Last question for the day. Ano ang CBE ulit?
TV parang ano lang po, yung tagan i-balance na lang po yung minus saka plus.
Ah, sige, sulat. Sige nga, sulat. Ano yung charge balance equation mo? Sige, what's your charge balance equation? Yan, dyan na lang sa ilalim. Buburahin ko sa ano. Sige, magbubura ako ha. Para magkasya. Ano? Uy, bakit mo binura? Nabura siya. Okay. CB ito. These are your MBEs.
Bila mo. Lalaan ko na po.
Oh, sulat lahat ng positive sa isang side. Sulat
Opo,
lahat
tapos
ng negative
sa
sa
lahat
ilang
eh.
side. Okay. And ita times mo yung charge dun sa species. Tama? Di ba ganun yun? Okay. Sige. Minus. Very good. Very good. Yeah. Naalala mo siya. Okay. Good. Okay. Good. Okay. Good. That's your CBE. Ang CBE laging isa lang yan. Oh, no! Laging isa lang yan, ha? Recall that. Laging isa lang ang CBE natin. Okay, so with that, we're good for today. Please remember, Joshua, I want you to review before we proceed sa next meeting tomorrow. 3 to 5 siguro tayo. Update na lang ako. 3 to 5 or 4 to 6 ulit. Update ako. Please review writing CBE and MBE. Okay? Pero tomorrow, we'll start with number 2, yung potassium hydrogen phthalate. Ang una kong ano doon sa'yo, task, ay isulat yung reaction ni potassium hydrogen phthalate. Okay? It's nice to see you again, Josh. And, ayun, again, Happy New Year. I'll see you tomorrow, ha?
Sige, Bong. Sige, Bong.
Sige, sige. Thank you.
Ako, bye-bye, Bong.